In today's tutorial, I will show you how to animate text inside of Premiere Pro. Let's begin. I already have my text ready on my timeline. These two texts are in one layer. If I select the text clip, you can see both texts in here. To animate the text, I will go to their transform settings and adjust the settings there. I'll also drop down the transform settings for the other text, focusing mostly on the position settings. I'll move my timeline forward by a second and then add a keyframe for its position. I'll do the same for the text below. Now, returning to the beginning of the timeline, I'll adjust the values to move the top text upward and the bottom text downward. Perfect! We should now see an empty screen. If I preview my timeline, we can see the text animate from off-screen to the center. This looks good, but I want to stylize the movement to make it less robotic. I'll select the first keyframe of the top text, right-click, and under Temporal Interpolation, I'll select Ease Out. Although it may not appear as if anything changed, if we drop down the Position menu, we can see the Ease Out animation curve that was created. I'll do the same for the last keyframe, but this one will be Ease In. Now, we can see a smooth curve. I'll repeat this process for the text below. Perfect! Now, with the animation adjusted, let's preview the final results. It's looking smooth, but I want to smooth out the ease in even more. So I will select the end keyframe and click and hold this handle here, then drag it towards the left. That looks good. I'll do the same for the text below. Now, I'll preview the animation again. Okay, I really like how this looks. For the second stage of the animation, I want the top text to push out towards the right, and the bottom text towards the left. I'll move my timeline a little closer. This is good. I'll go ahead and add the keyframe to both texts. Now, I'll move to the end of the timeline and change the position of the upper text towards the right. And move the bottom text all the way to the left. I'll now adjust the ease out and ease in for both texts. Okay, this looks good. Now let me preview the animation. This is looking really good. Now, what if you want to add some motion blur to your text? You can add a fast blur or a directional blur effect and animate its keyframes. However, I prefer doing it a different way. I'll head over to my second sequence. Now, in order for the motion blur effect to work with my method, I will need to separate my text into separate text layers. I have the top text here and the bottom text here. Now, for this method, I won't be animating the text transform settings like I did before. I'll actually use an effect called transform. Here it is. I'll click and drag the effect to both of my text clips. Okay, I'll select my top text clip, and I'll head to the effect control window. We won't pay attention to the vector motion area. We are only going to focus on the transform section. I'll move my timeline here, and add a keyframe to its position. I'll move to the beginning of my timeline, and move my top text upward, it would automatically add a keyframe for us. I'll preview the animation. Now, to add motion blur to the movement of our text, let's go and focus on the shutter angle section. By increasing the amount, we can see our text become blurry. The max limit is 360. Normally, I use 180, but for the sake of this tutorial, I'll make it 360. You can see that when I preview the animation, the text gets blurry when in motion. But when it stops, the motion blur is gone. To me, this is a better way of adding motion blur without having to animate a ton of keyframes. Okay, just like the first example, I'll now add some ease in and ease out to my keyframes. I'll drop down the position menu and adjust ease in keyframe. I'll preview the animation again. This is looking good. I'll do the same for the text below. I'll make sure to select the bottom text clip. I'll move my timeline to match the ending of the animation from my first text. And I'll add a keyframe to its position. I'll move my timeline to the beginning and move the text towards the bottom. Now I'll ease in and ease out my keyframes. I'll modify the ease in keyframe. And increase the shutter angle to 360. Okay, it's looking good. I'll move my timeline here, and now I'll create the second part of the animation. I'll add a keyframe to its position. And then head to the end of the timeline and move the text towards the left. I will now add ease in and ease out to both keyframes. And I'll repeat this for the top text. I'll fast forward this section. Okay, now let's preview our final animation. Perfect! This is looking good. And there you have it. You now know how to animate text inside of Premiere Pro. You can use this technique to create different types of animation. If you found this video helpful, please leave a like and subscribe to the channel. And if you would like to see more tutorials like this one, or download some project files, head over to the tutosdigital.com website. Till the next one!